Thank you guys for coming. You come around when I'm sleeping. You come around in my dreams. You're a vision in the night. A companion. David Hayden here. I reach out to touch you. Traveler through my imagination. Uh-oh. A denizen I can't control. You're my sweet apparition. Thank you. This is a song I wrote after a real bad week in Florida. But that's not really what the song is about much anymore.
Let Used Helen to tell be. You about it. Until we were asked to come and perform and do a show for the women, and I use that term lightly, at the Fort Worth Carswell Air Force Women's Prison. Not only did we get to do a show for the population, the general population, but those on death row. That was quite the experience. And we actually opened with this song. And I guess they really liked it, because at the end of the show, they asked if we could do it again. So we asked the powers that be, and they agreed to it. And we played it again for them. Well, that was the end of the show, and before we could pack up and leave, they had to all go back to their cells. And so as we packed up and got ready to leave the stark concrete paradise they lived in, we could hear them singing this song all the way back to their cells, and it just echoed. It was very, very haunting. So this song has definitely taken on a new meaning, and is a lot more than a bad weekend in Florida. It's called The Blues Are Behind Me.
Sunshine turns to rain, and anger turns to pain. The blues are behind. Blues are behind. One lover is leaving, the other is grieving. The blues are behind. The blues are behind.
While our hearts were young.
please, please, blues are behind. The blues are behind. My car don't want to run. Does it ring out? I never have no fun.
Yeah, right.
Blues are behind. It might be one line, that song. The blues are behind it. The blues are behind. Blues are behind.
You know the rest of it.
Gonna get interesting quick with only one layer on, huh?
Yeah.
Hello. Don't start without me. Okay.
Never do.
That's true. All right. Well, we're gonna do a tune for you guys that somebody was asking for this earlier. And it's one that we wrote about John and Julia Pillow back in the back. Oh, I didn't tell you all about that? No, it's really a song about, all about those Harley riders who you see every weekend who are doctors and lawyers during the week. And they're out riding around on their big bikes on weekend. But these guys are back here. They're the real deal. Aren't you, John? Aren't you, Julia? Yeah. So, hello, there it is.
There is some sound. Jam now.
Okay. I'll just play it. Why don't we just play it? Y'all will get it. You can sing along if you know it. Don't just make something up, we did. I don't really care what people say. I don't really care at all. And I don't really care just what they think. Really don't matter at all. And all I want is you by my side. Come on, baby, let's take a ride. And ride, ride. Ride on, baby, ride on into the night. Ride, ride, ride on, honey, everything will be alright. Cause I don't really care what people say. I don't really care at all. And I don't really care just what they think. Really don't matter at all. Cover ourselves with leather and pride. Then come on, baby, let's take a ride.
Ride, ride, ride on, baby, ride on into the night.
Ride, ride, ride on, honey, everything will be all right. Another round for you. That's not a problem. So,
ride, ride, ride on, baby,
ride on into the night. Ride, ride, ride on, honey, everything will be alright. Cause I don't really care what people say. I don't really care at all. And I don't really care what they think, really don't matter at all. Just feel the wind blow through your hair, free to go most anywhere. And ride, ride, ride on, baby, ride on into
No, you don't. It's not in the room. It's fine.
It's what?
In the room, it's fine. Wait. So, try it.
Test. Test.
Yeah. Yeah.
Okay.
You got enough.
All right. It's working.
Man, I thought it was breaking.
Hello.
Blind dog, how you doing? This is going to be a song we don't do very often. Actually, we're going to do a number of them tonight. The first song that we did, Sweet Apparition, was one we seemed to have dug out and hadn't done that in a long time. But this is a song that Helen wrote about me when I made a mistake with her when we were younger in our relationship and not very mature and a few months into it. And she called me on it with this song. So I'm going to be honest with you, so.
Wow, that's a first. Normally, I don't have a. Oh, there we are. Now, normally I say that, you know, this isn't auto. What the hell are you doing?
He's got a grin on his face.
That's Reno. That's Reno. That's okay. Christmas is coming.
Or not.
Or not for you. Anyway, yeah, it's called Online Affair, so I'm sure the title's pretty self-explanatory. Yeah. Although the end isn't true. I mean, but
could have been.
It could have been.
If I hadn't
easily.
Been a good boy.
That's right. Can you turn your guitar up a little bit?
Mm-hmm.
Thank you.
So, you want it there?
I'm such a diva.
No, really?
Bling.
Ooh.
Blingy bling.
There. Okay, we're good. Okay. You tell me another lie, what can I say? What should I do? You say that you're all mine, but you're spending time online talking to her, lusting someone new. She sounded like it's what you wanted to hear. She wished that you were near. You said you don't know why. Never meant to make me cry. Would you do it again? I thought you were my friend. Your own. wish I didn't
Getting through that's tough. On more ways than one. All right, guys. So we're going to do one of the more recent things, since that one was written about a long time ago, thank God. Well, I guess we've been together about 14 years now.
Maybe 14 years this month, yeah.
Yeah. And for y'all, just want to let you guys know a couple things real quick. Scott Fant and Paul Johnson will be here. Paul from Illinois is coming in, and Scott's from Ferris, and they'll be here the Saturday after Thanksgiving. It'll be a rockabilly night, because these two guys are both rockabilly as all get out. If y'all know either one of them, you know what I'm talking about, and it's going to be a lot of fun. And the way they never met each other. And when I first heard Scott, the first thing I thought about is I need to introduce him to Paul, because mm-hmm. they sure, but Paul's in Illinois. It wasn't real easy. So Paul came down to see me last year, and I invited Scott and his wife over. And I think, if I remember right, I introduced him and I left. They walked in the room and I introduced them to each other, and I left the house for 3 hours. Honest to God.
Yeah.
And I just left, and I thought, you know, they're either going to hit it off, and we're going to have a good show coming up the Saturday after Thanksgiving, or they're, you know, or it's not. And boy, when I got back, they were ready to do that show.
It's going to be good.
They'll be ready for you guys. And just if you want to help us out, this is the one night a year that we do take your tips in the tip jars right over there, that bucket. And if it isn't full, I'm going to shoot your ass. So it's other than And I'm not going to say anything else about it, because, you know, we don't like to go too deep into that. Let me check something here.
Tune it or die.
Mm-hmm. Everybody gets a turn. Everybody gets a turn here, huh?
Uh-huh. It's true.
Okay.
Yeah.
So, about a year ago, a couple of years ago now, woke up one morning and Helen was fixing to go to work, and I said, "You're John Lennon and you wake up in the world today. What are you going to write about?"
This is what I live with.
I said, you're going to wake up in a new world. He died in 1980, October 8th, wasn't it? 80. And she wrote a verse when she went to work, and I wrote an idea. When she got home that night, we compared them. I liked hers better. I liked the direction she was going, because, you know, hers went social and mine went political. Can you imagine that? we don't bring that into the studio, so we won't go there. So.
Yeah.
I dropped that idea and thought she had a better idea and wrote a second verse to it. And it's called Zombies. And one of the things that I kind of wanted to do in this song, because she'd written got a really good song started. I wanted to force myself to sound a little Beatle-ish. Need to have a little bit of
that. Doing the keys, never written in before.
I had to do it write it in a key I'd never written in before. That was one of the things I demanded of myself. So, and I still don't know what key this is, David, but David's got it figured out.
We're going to find out.
People do, and how they seem to hide inside. their cell phones and their iPads and their laptops and all their fads. They don't seem to talk a lot, but they text away like mad. I wonder if they're thinking what they're thinking. It kinda makes me sad, this IT obsession, addiction. It's a hypnotic trance. They stare at their little screen in the palm of their hand, wrapped up in their little world, head stuck in the sand.
About the way things are and how we came to be in a world full of zombies.
Zombies.
Where nobody's free of their ties to each other, like YouTube and Facebook and the Twitter disease. They're laughing and sharing even intimately the secrets of their past, their hopes and dreams. It's a narcissistic parade of mental amputees. It's a viral potpourri. They stare at their little world in the palm of their hands, wrapped up in their little world, like Village of the Damned. Damn. What's it coming to? Where will it end? Can we survive with synthetic friends? Thank you, by the way. That was kind of a fun one to write. And sometimes, you know, in songwriting, and one of the things that we do in here is we bring you songwriters, as y'all know. And we've got, just to let y'all know a little bit about Alan Hertz here with us tonight, who you guys give a hand to. He'll be here in just a few weeks with Ken Gaines and Greg Whitfield for our Christmas show. Y'all know that is always fun and always a packed house. So Alan's one of the reasons it's fun. Yeah, yeah. He's kind of pissy most
really,
of the time.
But you know.
But let you guys know, too, the start of next year, I'm just going to tell you about the two January shows. I won't go past that. You can look on the website. But first show of the year will be two of the most amazing female artists I've ever heard together. They live 5 miles apart near Austin and have never met. They're going to meet on this stage. Miss Karen Ma will join Tish Hinojosa here.
Mm-hmm. It's going to be a really good show.
Yeah, it'll be January 12th, I think. It's the second Saturday of January, and Pauline Reese will be here on the fourth Saturday of January, and she's going to have a special guest with her, and I'm not at liberty to say who it is yet, but it's wonderful.
It'll be good.
I'll tell you. I can't say it until the commitment's made. So.
And it says F.
Oh, yes. There, is that it?
Yes. This is a song that Randy wrote many, many moons ago, and we both do it, but he decided that I was going to do it tonight, so I guess I'm doing it. It's called A Year Now.
This song, yeah, this is kind of the song that might have got me known a little bit in the Dallas, Alan's old organization, Dallas Songwriters Association. No, they're a great organization. Yeah. They really are. I'm just joking. But that's where I won't say anything else. We'll just talk about that. All right. So, a year now.
It's been a year now since I met you, and I learned how to trust, and I bet you that it shows now in everything that I do. When I see you, my heart it beats faster, 'cause I'm tied to you like a slave to a master, and what I'm thinking, hoping I pray you'll come true. I feel the future brighter than sunshine, although I know I'm totally love blind. Wanna be with you every night and day, like kids again, phoning and flirting, and I'll have to admit, occasionally hurting when we say something that's totally misunderstood. It's been a year now, oh yeah, a year now, only a year now since I've been. Now,
Okay. So I went to the four for a minute. It's okay.
Lordy, lordy, lordy.
That's why I didn't want to do the song tonight.
Because you knew you were going to screw it up for me. Is that it? Yeah, thank you. Thank you so much.
Okay. All right. Well, this is a song. Yes, I'm Key. This is a song I wrote, God, is that long ago?
This was wife number two.
No.
Somebody's mics.
I didn't do it.
Yeah, I know, but something's going on there. I wonder if I need a new cord. You don't think, Ray? You're not getting it back there? I'm getting it in the speaker out here. It's just speaker. It's okay. We'll live with it. So I wrote this song in 1983, and I wrote it about Reno's mama. I had just met her, and she came to visit one time. Somebody's phone's ringing. I can feel it. You know, feel the vibrations.
Good vibrations.
You're not supposed to have
vibrations.
My phone back there. Good vibrations.
So sensitive.
Was I calling me? Okay. Yeah. Everybody text me at one time.
Yeah.
Okay. I'm not liking the speaker. Is it that one speaker? Yeah.
Yes.
I can correct that at halftime here. We're only a few songs away. It's not over there. It's in that speaker. It's not in that speaker.
Okay.
All right. Is it, y'all? That's what I'm hearing. Okay. Anyway, this is called Louisiana Lady with something else. Telephone. She's 500 miles away and I'm home all alone. Lady, think I've got the blues, 'cause I'm sitting here in Dallas, you're in Baton Rouge. Louisiana lady, you're sure looking fine. Your tender kiss, your warm caress, you're messing with my mind, lady. Think I've got the blues, 'cause I'm sitting here in Dallas and you're in Baton Rouge. David Hayden, y'all. Our meeting was a thing of fate. It must be destiny. If I can't come to see you soon, I hope you come to me, lady. Think I've got the blues, 'cause I'm sitting here in Dallas, you're in Baton Rouge. And I'm thinking I might need you, think you need me too. Pieces of the puzzle fit, and that's up to you, lady. Think I've got the blues, 'cause I'm sitting here in Dallas, you're in Baton Rouge. Play one more, David. Been a
hard day's night, and I've been working like a dog. It's been a hard day's night, and I've been sleeping
like a law. Cause when I get home to you, I find the things that you do will make you feel alright. And when I work all day to get your money to buy your things, and it's worth it just to hear you say you're gonna give me everything. So what I'm with you the most, cause when I get you alone, you know I'll feel alright. When I'm home, everything seems to be right. When I'm home, feeling you holding me tight. Time, yeah, it's been a hard day's night, and I've been working like a dog. Should be sleeping like a log. Cause when I get home to you, I'll find the things that you do will make me feel alright. You know I feel alright. You know I feel
a few more we're going to do, and then we're going to take a break, give y'all a break, and come back and do the best songs in the second set, of course. All right. This song is probably, I would just have to say, over the years, probably my most requested song, so I'll go ahead and put it out there right now. In 1998, I had been going through kind of a writer's block, as every songwriter goes through. And I think I just hit a spot where God was talking to me and said, you know, you're not writing anything, but you need to write one for me. And I found out a long time ago when I started writing, I'd never tried to write. And when I wanted to write, I prayed about it. And then the next day I knew I was writing. And when I wanted to learn to play guitar or sing or anything else, I always prayed about it first, and God seemed to answer the call. And so that was, anyway, this song, after a long writer's block, I think God just opened my doors to, the door of my mind to the Apostle Peter and what his thoughts might have been when he saw Jesus walking on water. You know, that was one of the premier events in human history. And so we're going to talk about that in this song. And this is kind of like what I think Peter might have said if he were sitting here with us today.
Mm-hmm.
guys and I were sailing out on old Galilee. John was getting some shut-eye, and Andrew was talking to me, when all of a sudden it happened. The storm came from out of the night, the wind and waves tossing us about. We're fearing for our lives, and just when we thought it was hopeless, Jesus to the rescue again. He made it calm in the bat of an eye, you know, the weather, it listened to him. You should have seen him walking, should have seen him walking across the water. You should have seen him walking, should have seen him walking across the water to me. I asked him, Lord, can I do that? And he just said, come, my friend. The water, it seemed so solid as I focused on him. And I was doing all right for a while, but then I glanced around. I saw the storm fearing again. You know, I started sinking down in the peril of the moment. It went away with the touch of his hand. Pull me up, put me back in the boat again, back with all of my friends. You should have seen him walking, should have seen him walking across the water. You should have seen him walking, should have seen him walking across the water to me. Just the way it is. When we take our eyes off the master, we get lost in our sin. But he's got an intercessor who loved us from the start. He'll save us from our difficulties, and he'll renew our hearts. You should have seen him walking, should have seen him walking across the water. You should have seen him walking, should have seen him walking across the water to me. You should have seen him walking. You should have heard him talking. Thanks. Thank you very much. Thank you very much. That was a, you know, it's one of those songs sometimes you wonder why you write songs, and It became a real easy. I saw a good friend of mine drop down on her knees and get saved in a coffee house one night to that song, and she's a minister now. So we'll leave it there.
She also took Reno to Israel recently, she and her husband. So. This is the most recent, not the most recent thing we've written, but it's the most recent thing we're going to play for you tonight. And I guess the best way to do this is just as simply call the 4th of July. And some of you have heard this song that we posted on YouTube and on Facebook. It's gotten about 3,000 or 4,000 hits on it and listened, so we appreciate the ones that have listened. It's a Helen and I were in Oregon this summer, and we on the 4th we were staying in Newport, and we had decided to drive down the coast, and down the Pacific coast we went on the 4th of July, and we went to every little town we could go to. We went to we fell in love with the town of Yahats. So if anybody in Oregon is listening, we love that town.
Yes.
So, but there were so many little towns on the coast that we went to, and it was all the 4th of July celebrations. And then we wanted to, we specifically got down to the dunes, which is in Florence, Oregon. And when we got to where we could see where the dunes started pretty much for the next 70 or 80 miles, we decided, well, that's as far south as we were going. We wanted to go back and see the only place really in Oregon where you can see a fireworks display, which is over water, because they don't allow them up there over land because of the forest fire potential. So they pop them like crazy out over the harbor there at Newport, and so we thought, we'll go back and see that. And that alone would have probably been enough to really inspire a song the day we spent. But I saw the strangest thing, y'all, and we'll show you a picture of it. Yeah, and, yeah, she did too. It's like my dad said, yeah, my dad did too. Okay. When the sun was setting that day, we were sitting down on the harbor front, and all the beautiful sailboats and everything. So it was placid. There was no wind blowing. It was like a mirror. It was gorgeous. Perfect day for fireworks too,
pink
because what, you know, pink, kind of pinky blue, dark blue sky with pink up high, and over the mountain range there to the east, when they started firing off the fireworks, a double rainbow came up.
It's gorgeous.
And it was the fireworks were going off in front of the rainbow, and Helen and I are sitting there like, phew, something
cool
you don't see every day.
Yeah.
Did you take pictures?
We did.
Yes.
We did. And we will show you those. But we'll play you those first.
Yep.
And so after they started the fireworks, Helen and I didn't even stay to see mainly the fireworks. We saw the rainbow in the fireworks and said, let's go back through them and write something about this. So
we did.
In B flat?
In B flat.
In B flat. Thank you. It's the 4th of July. Fireworks are flying, moon peeping over the ridge. Boats in the harbor ain't doing nothing, except waiting for a simple breeze. Kids on the boardwalk taking it all in, is only a munchkin can do. Parents are watching, doing their duty, professing the red, white, and blue. Ain't nothing like it, just like a rainbow, stars coming up in the sky. There's something special about the 4th of July. We line up on Main Street, bands are marching, twirlers throw their batons, and floats full of beauties, all of them smiling, everybody's having fun. Ain't nothing like it, just like a rainbow, stars coming up in the sky.
something special about the 4th of July. Dads are grilling, mamas are chilling, musicians playing their tunes. Fans at the ballpark root for the home team, that's what they're supposed to do. 'Cause there ain't nothing like it, just like a rainbow, the stars up above in the sky. There's something special about the 4th of July. Their hands on their hearts. Old Glory waves, she always stands guard. 'Cause there ain't nothing like it, just like a rainbow, the stars up above in the sky. There's something special about the 4th of July. It's the 4th of July. Fireworks are flying, moon peeping over the ridge.
Thank you.
Yeah. Oh, thank you. Thank you. I want to play that for President Trump in the White House. That's what I'd like to do. I think he would like it. I think I can, don't y'all?
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Why not? Somebody's going to entertain him that day. He's been very entertaining. I'll say that. And what key are we doing this in?
Okay. The key of C.
True C.
Yeah. See, remember that time that you threw me under the
bus?
Yeah.
Well, I didn't throw you under the bus.
Oh, you did.
I didn't even see the bus.
Yeah, I sure as hell did.
So we're doing a
live broadcast, okay, from Austin, Texas.
Live radio show.
Yeah, and so you know, Randy does one
key
of his songs, and Mudcat does one of his songs.
I forgot the key.
And then he starts with mine, and he like starts it out, and he's in the totally different key than what
she
I do.
She sang
this song
the hell out of it that day.
And I'm
I meant
like,
to tell y'all,
Randy,
she
you're
did
in the wrong key.
I said, tough. And, I'm not stopping.
I said, you need to start over, and he's like, huh. I thought, oh my God.
She did
God
a great job, though. In fact, we should do it in that key.
I
though
don't think so.
If you're feeling kind of low, world is moving slow, think again. If you're worried all night that something ain't right, think again. Life is what you make, you control your fate. Makes no sense to whine, you just be wasting time. So think again. Yeah, think again. If you're in a dead-end job, enough to make you sob, think again. If there's nowhere else to go and you got no time to show, think again. Life is what you make, you control your fate. Makes no sense to whine, you just be wasting time. So think again. Yeah, think again. What you got for me, David? Thought you had a friend who'd be there till the end, think again. If you think you're hearing lies, don't be taken for a ride, think again. makes no sense to whine. You'd just be wasting time. So think again. Yeah, think again. Think again.
So we're going to do one more, Reno, and then take a break. Okay. How far are we in?
An hour and
4. Oh, well. How's your bladders? Y'all got another song in you? Be at the bottom, won't it?
I don't know, because I can't see anything.
Okay, well, usually in alphabetical order, but... Okay.
Looks like G to me.
I know, that's what...
G to you, too?
Huh? So it looks like you G look to really me. Good.
I'm not sure. I'm
not on drugs. I don't do drugs. This is natural. All natural crazy. Sounds about right
sounds
to
about
me.
Right. We were trying to figure out what key the song's in. But the way I tune my guitar, between the way I tune and then try to figure it out, so it's a little different. But so this song, just to give you a little backdrop on it real quick, is a song the lady, that the wonderful lady that that I used to date before I met Helen.
You notice he's got all these songs about all these, like, women from the past.
I had dated
stuff.
Her for 4 years, and this is the only song I got out of the deal, okay? No, actually, I got two, but this was an ending song. And this is like one of those songs that you write is, huh?
Where are the Helen songs?
Oh, they're, honey.
He's got one.
Everything. Second set, though.
Your eyes.
So, where do you go after that? Maybe we just take a break now.
Oh, man.
Okay, good one, Alan. I like that.
Hit him hard.
And that's just him on one shot at me. Imagine Christmas when he gets Ken and Greg both to pick on.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm in the back, and we all get to pick on Alan, so
yeah,
it's all good.
I'm on the front row.
Because your ass is mine on Christmas. I'll be back there, and you're going to sound real fun. You thought you were high singing before?
Didn't you have that Donald Duck effects thing put on?
Yeah, but I need to get Shelly McBride up here to do that before me.
Oh, okay.
He does better Donald than Donald. So anyway, this is a song I wrote is a chastising song originally. And it was one of those, you'll never have anybody like me again. You know, okay, I almost just shake your finger. You know, okay, shake your finger. And I'm no politicians. I'm not going to get into that. But anyway, you get it. You get it. So...
But it turned out to be a lovely love song after he got past the anger and the bitterness.
Sarcasm.
Yeah.
Changed a few words.
Yeah. Yes.
Well, you know, Yesterday by the Beatles was originally called Scrambled Eggs. It was. And he took it to Paul McCartney. He took it to George Martin, and George said, you know, it's too good a melody to have silly song, write me some other lyrics. Most recorded song in history started out as Scrambled Eggs. So this one started out with a different purpose, and it ended up here. We'll take a little break after this song. If y'all fill the bucket up, I'll let y'all out of the room. Never have another lover who can do what I can do. Take the time to please you, touch you with a love so true. You'll never have another lover Make it good when you are blue. Take away your trepidations. Focus totally on you. No other lover. Never have another lover. Love you through eternity. When you wake up every morning, you be looking right at me. You'll never have another lover. Make love so tenderly. Snuggle through the night and kiss you till the morning comes to be. Never need that other lover. I ain't going anywhere. I'll always be beside you, bringing you my lover's prayer. You'll never have another lover. Make love so tenderly. Hold you through the night and kiss you till the morning comes to be. No other lover. Thank you. And we're going to take a break for, oh, I don't know, a few minutes. Y'all can come buy some t-shirts and things like that if you want to. We are working on an album right now. We'll have a new one pretty soon. I don't have any of the old things, so there's no product for you to buy. But if you want to buy a t-shirt, we got the Make Americana Great Again. And we've got the Waxahachie City Limits. And I see four or five Ride with the Devil shirts, so I appreciate those.
Yeah.
That song is coming up shortly. It's coming up in the second
My
set.
My song. So,
we do have that on the list. Actually, we don't have that on the list, do we? Gosh, are we going to do that song tonight?
I'm betting you will.
All right.
I'm betting you will.
Well, we'll do it the second set. Okay. So we'll take a break for a few, y'all.